holding in. So on the LlamaLand side right now, blue will be, we can see a switch they have. Kandeme last time played the Maul, I believe. Right now he's on short, on the longbow with light armor. Other than that, we can see much, much, much more short swords. Only one Maul player, so this is definitely a big difference. I guess it makes sense. You cannot throw that easily when you are attacking, throw enemy away with Maul. So interesting thing to see. And on the Team Kitten, we can see one light armor player, Pisesh Pisesh, playing dual blade. So I think this is first dual blade of the tournament. Interesting to see. Other than that, one medium armor with the musket and everyone else heavy armor. What about the units, CB?
Yeah, units. I almost thought that we were going to see a lot of Kef on the LlamaLand side, but they switched around quite a bit. So we're seeing still a lot of Kef, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Farmingers again, and quite a few Berserkers there as well. Kind of similar to the first setup. On the defense side, we see a lot of Javelins, and it looks like Kitten has decided to bring some range this time. Quite a few Zakalia Militia, maybe they're trying to use them based on what they just saw being used against them. But same for LlamaLand, we see that they also bring a lot of Zakalia Militia, not for their first units, of course. We see the Martyrtori coming in again, as Kittens start with a lot of Javelins, actually, in their first lineup.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so if LlamaLand will push on the same side that Team Kitten pushed a moment ago, this might be a very good idea, right? You have a plus point very close in, you can resupply very fast, and you can keep these javelins flowing and flowing and flowing forward. So we will see where it goes. For now, let's maybe actually take a look at some of the player skins, because we have not do that earlier. So we have Tank Mobile in the new skin, with the sea, I forget the name, but yeah, with the octopus at the top. You can see some interesting schemes from the players all around. Kappa with the very classic skin, since start of the game it is, I like this skin very nice.
Yeah, it looks amazing. But yeah. And we can see that LlamaLand are not wasting time, they're using their trebuchets to clear out the artillery already. On the right side of the gate, left side of the gate, the same. And look at the left side, looks like Kittens are rushing out.
I mean, they tried, so three people scouting ahead. They don't have any cavalry, so I don't think they are rushing. This is more defensive scouting, but and very aggressive one from Berserker, actually, so aggressive scouting. But yeah, they are just looking around, creating pressure, making sure that the LlamaLand team will respect their presence here, right? If you have people roaming around, you need to watch at them, you need to be, you know, take a look at them. You don't have as easy job of doing whatever you want. Other than that, we can see artillery flying around, destroying all the cannons. As you said earlier, two trebuchets used to destroy some of the crucial ones. And a little bit different approach to the towers. Tower is not pushed at all, the middle one is being pushed. Let me go closer. Ah, okay. Very nice shooting them from Team Kitten on the defense. They managed to destroy all the towers that were pushed. So nice, interesting stuff here. But LlamaLand right now trying to get the gate up. They just pushed it very closely but not finished it. So it seems like they want to have it ready for the last moment. Or they just want to clear out the bombs from above the gate before they finalize the gate push. On the small gate, the stalemate is still here.
Yeah, very surprising that they managed to take out two towers after we saw the traps being used on the artillery there, as we did see one death from a player of Team Kittens who was too far away in the LlamaLand attacking zone. But nothing else really going on right now. Surprisingly, something that you don't see too often is that the unit count for the attacking team is even lower than the defending team, so you can see that they are not bringing too many serfs or gray units. They have pretty pretty low unit count currently.
Mm-hmm. I think most of it comes from the gray pikes, so they are quite numerous in parts of the defenders.
So they got three of them and they are only 12.
Yep. So let's see how it will be put to the use, but for now there is not too much to look at, to be honest, right? And the first initial tower destruction was very crucial for the time, from the time perspective. Look how much time already passed, and the attackers are exactly like they just heal like they spawned, right? The artillery is gone, yes, great. But other than that, they are not any much more forward towards capturing the last point. So very good job from Team Kitten. Definitely much, much better idea, much better tactic than what they executed in the first game.
Yeah, and I'm surprised they're defending the little gate so heavily. They continually have 4 or 5 people on the small gate, as they do set up on the staircase as well, which is where we expect the biggest attack. But they certainly seem to expect something surprisingly, maybe.
Mm-hmm. And we can see that Keipa and Cabanas is controlling all the movement over here, so only 2 players. We have a lot of players nearby if they would be required. But Team Kitten very nicely riding out and riding in, right? They are right now going to hide, and maybe they will go out once more and try to, you know, grab the attention. So LlamaLand cannot be fully sure. You know, when you come to the tournament, you have some tactics, you have some maps drawn out, you have some plans, everyone is aware. If you throw some of the cogs into the whole machine, block some things, right? Maybe Keipa was supposed to do something important somewhere else, right? And they cannot do it. Or Cabanas right now, looking that the Berserker is coming behind them, he needs to watch out. Making sure that the chaos is there, chaos, and the enemy cannot do what they want is also crucial thing of the, you know, whole battle and strategy, right? How it will be executed.
And we can see LlamaLand grouping up on the left tower, so this attack is going to be different than what we've seen before. They're also having a few players on the right tower, and they've brought a lot of Lanzknechts, field shields, berserkers, and for Duraccio and pikes, of course, well, but also some ranged.
Yep. So the balanced approach is once more here from the LlamaLand. The push is coming in. Very nicely done. Team Kitten, they are pushing out and they are capturing the plus, but it is too late. All of the units pretty much are already upstairs. And right now the fight is for the A point. With all the trebuchets flying in and very good split of the units across the 2 towers, seems like LlamaLand are doing this very, very nicely. The losses that are here are very, very scarce. They are just blocking here with few shields, few azaps and so on. But other than that, it was free push for the A point. Team Kitten.
The small push from the right side on the tower was just distracting Team Kitten too much. And look outside, there's a few Kitten players with Kev outside, but they were caught with their tail between their legs. They were too late.
Yeah, they captured both supply points outside, but the question is, will this be sufficient, right? I mean, you see, Ordinary spawned in and he's right away at the action with full unit left. So the cavalry players from Team Kitten missed this player. And this is very problematic, because what LlamaLand is doing right now, they have noticed. 3 players are outside. They are not coming here anytime soon. Let's push it. They have not even finished capping A point. They are doing the full push forward, utilizing the bad coordination from the Team Kitten and bad pretty much rotation, right? They didn't rotate fast enough. They are still moving forward. They have the advantage of speed, so they are utilizing it and gaining as much territory as they can.
Yeah, but this is really interesting from Kittens, because LlamaLand doesn't have any supply, so they need to either win or die together and come back. As the Kev is coming back from outside to the gates, they're in quite a few of the units. We can see that the unit count is almost exactly equal, which means that Team Kitten has actually killed 100 more, or 50 units more. But over to you to the fight here.
Yeah. And Barry can very nicely counter charging in the back of the enemy enemy cavalry. So nice counter push from LlamaLand with the cavalry. He spawned with it a moment ago and coming in here trying to help his team. Well, how this is going on for LlamaLand, I guess it was a little bit expected. They tried their luck with pushing this forward. It didn't work out. So they just lost like 1 or 2 units and they are moving back to regroup, constantly shooting with archers from above. Remember, archer units have bonus damage if they are shooting from above of the enemy. So this is nice utilization of the archers. A lot of damage was dealt here, and they are going to just retreat. Recapture their point, they still have 9 minutes left, so not that much time lost. And they are just going to slowly think about their next steps, and we can slowly as well think about the statistics.
Yes, quite so. We can see four traps being used. We can see that quite a few players from LlamaLand went down. But nothing too much at Brave. Hakan actually got killed twice already. Once by the Deal Blades, so it looks like Kisha Pisha is quite sufficient at the Deal Blades. As for the unit kills, we got pretty similar to what we've seen from the start. It's a 100 unit difference, so it's the same difference that we had at the beginning, as both teams have almost killed exactly the same. 347 for LlamaLand, 343 for Kittens. The units that they're bringing on the field right now, there's quite a few Armingers for LlamaLand, also some Zikali and Militia. And Kittens are starting to bring out some Kef as well, as they continue to bring out a lot of Imperial Pikes and only one Shield Wall. As they're grouping at the gate, seems to be that they are defending at the gate, but also at the same time, LlamaLand is starting to move up as they see that the gate is heavily defended.
Yeah, sorry for that, I was switching some options. Seems like the attack is coming in. They have chosen a little bit different approach right now with splitting their forces for the small gate and for the left tower. So it seems like the same stairs will be utilized for the attack from LlamaLand. They are right now being attacked from the back from Tizzy, and Tizzy being a little bit misplaced, going to die here very soon, and he did. And yeah, unit count very similar. Still 11 trebuchets left. Unfortunately for the attackers, there are not too many places you can use them close to the wall, because the wall just will block all the damage. They are trying to think about what they can do now. They have four entry points, two gates and two stairs. Right now, seems like they are going to have the most push here on the one side, and they are going to maybe send someone on the flank. Kepa and Eldaria moving there on the flank. Sexy Kebab and Isaac watching from the top, shooting with archers, countering enemy archers. So very nice counter archery happening here with this unit over here, shooting at right now at the pikes. Very nicely done. And we can see that once more the Kalyan Militia being the key thing to push forward. The stack from Ticket and was prepared. Unfortunately, they had to move out. They would just burn, so they had to move out. Very nicely done. Right now, the defense is quite scarce. They don't have any good position for the Team Kitten. And LlamaLand, if they will attack once, if they will attack strongly right now and watch for the flanks from the cavalry, I think they will be able to achieve something good there. They are slowly coming back. They are expecting a lot of attack from the Team Kitten. They are not sure where Team Kitten units are, because indeed you cannot see them. They're hidden around. They have few units here, few units there. But the main force of Team Kitten is missing. They are not sure where it is, and they are not pushing that aggressively because of that. Team Kitten on the other end is counter pushing the flank. So the flank we were talking about from the other stairs earlier right now is retreating. They have to. Marv very nicely blocking this push, and they are moving more aggressively towards the plus. They have gone down from the stairs fully, and the cavalry push from the back is coming in, very nicely countered by the pikes. Most of the cavalry is down, but the other unit is here. And will it do good damage? No, it will be countered by another pike. So very well played. But this one, yeah. This one they will not be able to do so. So a lot of cavalry, nicely, one by one by one by one. Pretty much four cavalry charges used and killed a lot of units from LlamaLand, but not all of them. There is still some that are here on the stairs and trying to push. So very interesting fight. Not something totally different than what we've seen in the first game. In first game, everything was happening in one place, one moment, pretty much 30 seconds gone. Here, the fight is like 3 minutes and in five places. A very interesting thing to watch. And seems like right now, LlamaLand don't have enough units. They will have to regroup a little bit. On the other parts of the map, we see Kepa coming in with cavalry, Berserker countering him with Tizzy, so seems like all of this is under control. And good that I looked around, because here we have Eidaria fighting with Ramses to be able to capture the point. He was able to do it just for a few percent, but right now the Ramses with his cavalry coming in definitely will have the upper hand here. On the other end of the map, we can see LlamaLand starting to go down and putting much more pressure on the placent. Nevash getting some units, Kisser Spicers also with javelins rearming. Will they be able to capture it with just few units here to their utilization? Might be very hard, especially that the shields moved too fast and they pretty much died for free. In the behind we have Imperial Arquebuser, but they have no cover, so they need to retreat. They are getting flanked by the cavalry, so very poorly timed attack here from LlamaLand.
Yeah, LlamaLand is moving left to right to left, as Kittens are trying to continue attack on them with Gav from different sides. We see the units dropping a little bit, but they stay so even for so long. As we see that LlamaLand is trying to move to the left supply, as Kittens is actually clearing up at the front gate. So the LlamaLand push on the left side is moving on.
Yeah, so they are going to push the plus. And remember, 3 minutes left, no more time will be added at all. So still 11 trebuchets left, that's a lot of trebuchets left. You can see Sexy Kebab going to pressure the point here for a moment. You'll receive a lot of damage from Reanisaris. Yes, horse is dead, but he will get some attention, that's a good thing. And then LlamaLand going to push the plus side. Think it and defending here still with short sword, they will not be able to die so fast, so definitely some time will be bought here. And trebuchets, come on, 11 trebuchets left, use them, cut the enemy supplies off, cut anything off. The rotations from Team Kitten from behind is coming very heavily, and if LlamaLand will not use trebuchets here, I think it will be over. 2 minutes and 30 seconds left, not too much time left to push.
Yeah, totally, and we can see that there's continually being a few players being killed as on the supply, this might be big, General.
Yeah, for these trebuchets, right in the middle, there's going to take a little bit of the units here. Unfortunately, Bravehack and no more units, he's just alone, going to probably die in a moment. And yeah, LlamaLand, even though the plus was there, the idea was there, the plan was there, the units were there, they took so much time and were so disorganized that in my opinion, this is what made them pretty much lose all the push here. Marv trying to push.
Totally. We saw at the beginning that they wanted to come in from different sides, looked amazing, but after a while they just were too split up maybe, as they tried to continue kept the final, but we see that they are still so close in units, so with a minute 30 left, let's see if they can get this supply on the right side and still make a quick push, but they need to be so fast on this one.
Yes, and seems like the timing is very very good, like not bad for the attackers. LlamaLand just pounding with a lot of people in front of the main gate, and they are going to rush the main cap. And we have a lot of units also coming here from the right side. Unit-wise, it's very similar. Trebuch, still 10 of them used, not used. This should be already here. Come on, place it somewhere. Use it at least somewhere. 1 minute left. Why are you keeping so much trebuchets?
Yeah, they just gotta drop those, and they are actually 2 players short on LlamaLand. Brave Hakan as well as Marv is down, so this might be a big difference in the end as well.
Yeah, currently it's actually 4, only 11 alive from LlamaLand versus 15 Team Kitten, full defense. They are not allowing them to even come to the last point. Very nice advances all around, stopping the advance, the push from the LlamaLand here in this corner. LlamaLand having much more units here, they are slightly getting the upper hand, but it's taking so much time that it will not allow the LlamaLand team to pressure the last point.
That's just too late. We finally see traps coming in on the final, but we see some players on left supply as well, but they didn't even need it. So you gotta wonder what they were thinking here. As they do manage to get through, but it's too late, right?
Yeah, what we said a moment ago. They're coming in, they had this nice idea, nice push, but too few trebuchets, too slow on the movement and not aggressive enough. Yes, they reached the last point, that's great, but unfortunately, 1 more minute is missing. Maybe, only maybe, if they would be able to defend the towers at the beginning and not lose this additional minute or 2 minutes for the push, maybe this would allow LlamaLand to take a win here. But yeah, with such a small time left, they were not able to get it pushed through, and they were able to win it. So, moving now to the statistics shortly, we have Brave Hakan on MVP on LlamaLand, and once more, a lot of unit kills, 200. This we'll have to check later on, but I believe this is record for the tournament, 200 kills so far, very good job. 236 for the statistics, so fighting till the end, 3 deaths, nice thing, nicely done. Another points, key highlights here will be 3 kills on Isaacs, and Kepa, Codeine, Marv, and Silent also having 2 more kills. 10 assists on Bedir, good job here. And for the units, only one more player crossed 100 mark. Silent one, nicely done. When it comes to the team Kitten, we have MVP in the fair. He's 406, so very nice stats. And 189 units on top of that. So very, very well played from fair. Then we can also see Avenger and Tizzy having over 100 units. And when it comes to the kills, we can see Kisash Pisash, 4 kills, 1 death. I would like to see if all of these kills were hero kills or unit kills, but definitely nicely done with the dual blade. He didn't die as much as we could expect, so nicely done.
Yeah, quite so. And like you said, Brave Hakan putting in the numbers there is trying to get his whole team on his back, but he just couldn't do it all on his own. He actually was dead before the final push 3 times, so he couldn't participate in that final fight. And as you can see, that might have been a difference for LlamaLand, because they seem to rely so heavily on him, at least in this attack. Whereas Kittens, they were very good on the rotations. I mean, we saw at the first game that they just pushed on one side, and they seem to have learned quite a bit from LlamaLand. So yeah, interesting defense from Kittens, really well done. But let's take a look at the clip that we have. As we can first take a look at the first attack at A point.
Mm-hmm. Yep, so here we go with the clip.
So what was so interesting to see here, I'm sorry, I was switching channels here, is that LlamaLand actually split up, right? 10 of them at the left side, 5 of them at the right side. And you can see that the right side group is just scaring Kittens off. They just don't dare come closer, as they know they can get trapped. And this is such an effective way for them to capture this A point here. On the map, you can see that some of the cap from Team Kitten is getting all the supplies, which has been impacting the next push. But very effective from LlamaLand here. Not too many units were lost, but you can see there at the end, the traps come in, and that's what Team Kitten was scared of.
Very well executed indeed. Moving on to the second one.
Yeah, this is nothing much going on, which is what we saw in the second part after A, right? LlamaLand tried to go left, go right, but they didn't really push down because they apparently weren't sure where Team Kitten was. And I wonder, General, what do you think here? Should LlamaLand just have made a big push for any of the supplies? Because Team Kitten was on the ground, but LlamaLand cleared out the range really well. Which you can see all the dead Namcons there on the ground. But they just took too long, I think, to really push down the stairs and get to the supply there.
Mm-hmm. I stopped the clip for a moment here at the end, looking at the map, right, and analyzing your question. Basically, Team Kitten were very nice in their defense. They played much more fluently and reacted very well to what was happening. Look at that. They had still one person at the back plus, so they are defending with one less person. There is one person defending small gate, so they have two less people to defend. So considering that, I think they were very nice. This was a very nice tactic. When you usually push, or you do something in the tournament, you expect the teams to move together to, you know, see a blob of units here or there, you know, maybe one side, maybe two sides, maybe even sometimes they attack from three sides. But there will be a parts of map where there will be a lot of red or blue color. Here, Team Kitten have chosen totally different approach. They were scarced around whole map pretty much, around the entry points, right? They were not at the entry points. They were harassing much more. So this is definitely a good highlight point for the Team Kitten. They have brought much more damage dealing units. But yeah, they were visible, a few Namcas here or there, maybe some javelins around, and that's pretty much it. Everyone else were hidden around the corners, were hidden around the valleys, and were waiting with either pikes to counter advance, with cavalry from different directions. And what we seen during the game itself, that they bring 4 cavalry to the one place, but they staggered the cavalry coming in, like every 5 seconds there was another charge or something like that. So there was charge, and then charge, and then charge, and then charge. So throughout the whole 20 seconds, you had constant cavalry charges coming from all the directions, and the LlamaLand were not prepared for that. They countered first two or three of them very well, but the last one crushed all the remaining defense and the push was over.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think you can also see in this final clip that, or this clip that we just showed, that LlamaLand, of course, had pushed the A points, and they were probably down at quite a few units as well. And maybe they weren't convinced that they had what it took to push for that supply, because Kittens did have the supply, as we saw in the game before, that the short supply resupply route is just so effective on the defense here.
Definitely. So maybe instead of pushing directly here, maybe attackers should try to pressure the small gate a little bit more, because the pluses on small gate, when you look at the small gate, both of the pluses for attacker and for defender are approximately same size. So this could be much more balanced, but that's one thing. And the second thing is actually the trebuchets. Here, you cannot use your biggest advantage, your trebuchet, anywhere. On the left plus, right, on the behind, the plus behind the wall and that whatnot, it's quite open and maybe you cannot use it everywhere, but there is a lot of places where you potentially could use the trebuchet, and this could be a game changing. So yeah, this is maybe, if anyone else will be playing on that map, maybe a thing to consider. All right, for now, let's move to the